In this video, we'll be looking at discriminants. The discriminant is a feature of a quadratic equation. Let's start by looking at the solutions of a quadratic equation using the quadratic formula. The expression under the square root symbol, b squared minus 4ac, is called the discriminant. The discriminant is important as it tells us how many real solutions the quadratic equation has. If the discriminant is positive, then it will have two square roots, so the formula will lead to two distinct real solutions. That means two different real solutions. If the discriminant is zero, then there will just be one square root, so therefore the formula will lead to just one repeated real solution. And if the discriminant is negative, then there'll be no real square roots, and the formula will not give us any real solutions. Read the wording of an exam question carefully. It might simply say that the equation has real solutions. In this case, there could be one or two, so we combine the two statements and say the discriminant is greater than or equal to zero. Let's look at how the discriminant of a quadratic affects the graph of that quadratic. If the discriminant is positive, then the graph will intersect the x-axis at two distinct points. If the discriminant is zero, then the graph will just touch the x-axis. In other words, the x-axis will be a tangent to the graph. And if the discriminant is negative, then the graph does not intersect the x-axis at all. This means the graph is either always positive, and therefore is above the x-axis, or is always negative, and therefore is below the x-axis. Let's have a go at a worked example where we have to find unknown constants in a quadratic equation. So pause the video and try it for yourself first. Firstly, we need to find the values of a, b, and c. They're just the coefficients of x squared, x, and the constant term. Then we need to determine whether the discriminant is positive, zero, or negative. So the key phrase in the question is exactly one solution. This means the discriminant is zero. We can then substitute our values for a, b, and c into that equation and then simply solve it using algebra, and we should end up with two values for k. If you have time at the end of your exam, then you can always check your answers are correct by substituting in the values of k to form two quadratics. And then using your calculator, you can solve those quadratics and check that each one has only one solution. You might have noticed in the question, it says k cannot equal 1. Well, if k equals 1, then the equation would just turn into a linear equation, which would have one solution. So therefore, by saying k cannot equal 1, it eliminates this case. In summary, the discriminant is used to determine the number of real solutions to a quadratic equation, or the number of roots of a quadratic graph. The formula for the discriminant is b squared minus 4ac. And if this is positive, then there's two distinct real solutions or roots. If it's zero, then there's one repeated real solution or root. And if it's negative, there's no real solutions or roots. If the number of real solutions or roots is known, then a discriminant can be used to form an equation or an inequality to find the value of any unknown coefficients of the quadratic. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.